John Bowlby is described as the father of the attachment theory. But is he? If you read any popular text on child psychology, you are bound to come across the name John Bowlby, who is frequently described as the father of the attachment theory. It is therefore perhaps surprising to find the description of his work given by two well-known authors, Karen Oliver and Louise Ellaby Jones, in their book Psychology and Everyday Life. The book looks at psychology within recognizable everyday situations, introducing some of the fundamental ideas and controversies. In the chapter called Children's Development, it includes the following fictitious exchange to illustrate the real nature of Bowlby's contribution. Carol: do you know if a child doesn't have a mother, it will turn out to be a weirdo and won't be able to form relationships with other people? It may even become a psychopath. Alex: where on earth did you get that rubbish from? Carol: I read it in a book. Alex: how old was the book? Carol: dunno, it was an old book called Child Care and the Growth of Love by a man called John Bowlby. I found it propping up the bottom of a bookshelf at my gran's. Alex: well, you should have left it there. The authors say that the final conclusion of Bowlby's beliefs was that children who were deprived of a mother over the first 5 years of life would have their social development affected and would be extremely likely to become juvenile delinquents. They may even develop what Bowlby described as affectionless psychopathy. They refer to the countless studies cited by Bowlby, all of which they say point to the fact that maternal deprivation seems to be the key feature in children's lack of emotional development. The main critic cited for the scathing attack on Bowlby is Professor Sir Michael Rutter. Although they say that Bowlby mellowed in later years and agreed that fathers may also be just as important, Rutter makes the point that it is the nature of the relationship which is the most important factor, and goes on to say that a child does not necessarily need only one primary caregiver. The two authors say that perhaps the most important argument that Rutter makes is that many children who have lost their mothers as a result of death do not suffer the long-term effects suggested by Bowlby, and say that it is more likely to be the type of bad feeling going on in families, for example when parents are separating or divorcing, that will affect the child. So, given these factors, why is John Bowlby still regarded by many as the father of the attachment theory?